a video that was circulating around the internet. You may have seen it, and it involved, I'm reading from the coach's page here. He says that there was an adult purple belt that came into his gym, about 250 to 265 pounds, pretty big guy, adult purple belt. And then he was rolling with his 140-pound teenage son, right? So a much smaller person. You're talking about almost double the body weight there. And he ends up, the smaller guy, the son, the blue belt, gets him locked into a triangle, not a very tight triangle, just like a triangle lock. And then the big guy, the 250-plus pound guy, picks the kid up and boom, dumps him right on his neck, right? Gives the kid a gnarly bump on his head. And he says it ends up giving him a pretty nasty concussion. Now, the guy blamed it on the kid for spazzing out, but, you know, he's showing the videos like, you be the judge. And there was nothing spazzy about it. But this illustrates a really important lesson that I want to make sure is out there, because especially to the white belts getting into this, maybe even blue belts, because this is something where I just got back from the ADCC 2022 championships at the time of recording this, and I met a ton of you guys. Like, I've never taken so many damn pictures in my life, and I do so happily, had a blast meeting you guys. But one of the interesting things that I noticed was that a lot of you guys, I took pictures with white to black belt all over the place, right? So it wasn't just like one particular belt group. But one of the things that's kind of interesting that I forget about is I've been doing these videos with you guys for like a long time now. We're getting like, we're like past the half decade point, right? So been 5-6 years. And a lot of you guys who are purple belts and brown belts and so on, you've been watching me since you were really new to jiu-jitsu. And I was one of those people that kind of helped you along. Like, you had your regular coaches and people in your gym, and then you would watch my videos and get some ideas. And I find that even from the white belts, they're like, bro, you make this whole thing simpler for me. I'm like, great. So I'll just kind of carry that torch and be like, I'm going to help grow this damn sport up more and try to make this whole thing simpler. And so with that, this is a valuable lesson to learn from if you're a white belt, blue belt, or someone that maybe hasn't traveled or trained with a lot of new bodies. And that lesson is that you don't ever roll with someone you've never rolled with before and expect them to, especially if they're from another gym, and expect them to abide by the normal rules of engagement that you are used to, right? In this case, the guy picked the kid up and slammed him, right? Now, that's for all of us watching that, we're like, what a dick, right? You're a purple belt. You know better. You don't pick a kid, a teenage kid, and dump him on his head when it's jiu-jitsu versus jiu-jitsu. We'll talk about fighting and self-defense in just a bit. But when it's in this situation, you don't do that, right? We don't do that stuff. You're not supposed to. But again, you don't know the person you're rolling with. And so you should always engage with them with a level of caution that you would reserve for almost a fight situation. Not that you want to get into that situation, but just in case. Because you just never know. I've had situations where over the years, people have tried to take my head off. I remember having a white belt. I was like rolling with him and he was a big dude. He picked my ass up off the ground and was getting ready to slam me. And I said, whoa, stop. And he's like, what? I was like, because, you know, I'm taking it easy on the guy. I could have put him in a really tight position and stop the whole thing from the beginning. But, you know, I'm moving around and picks me up. And I say, man, stop for a second. I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, well, you know, I watched the fights with Rampage Jackson. I watched him slam the guy and knock him out. You know, I was like, okay, cool. I was like, well, what happened to that guy afterwards? And he was like, well, he was knocked out and whatever. I'm like, yeah. I was like, do you want to knock me out and give me a concussion and, you know, maybe possibly mess my neck up? And he looks and goes, oh, sorry, bro. You know, he's like, he didn't even think about it, right? And, you know, again, this is, I don't judge him for it. I mean, it's one of these things where this guy was a brand new white belt. And it's one of those things where I've had to talk to people about wearing their shoes off the mat, right? They go to the bathrooms without their shoes on. They're coming with their feet. I'm like, hold on a second. We got to wipe those feet down. They're like, why? I'm like, think about all the germs that exist in the bathroom. And they're like, I'm like, would you lay your face down in the bathroom? And they're like, no. Why? The germs. They're on your feet now. Oh, right. It makes sense now. It's like, we're trying to keep staff and ringworm down to a minimum. So these things happen. And there was even a tournament one time where I remember I was watching this advanced division where there was this kid who was a teenage purple belt. And then he was up against a local amateur MMA fighter. The kid's tooling him 12 points ahead of on points. They're in the guard position with the MMA fighter on top. There's maybe less than a minute. I don't know. It wasn't much time, less than a minute. The MMA fighter picks this kid up. Boom, dumps him. Knocks the kid out, and I was the ref, so I pushed the guy away, and then, you know, the coach came and was checking on the kid, and I looked at him, I was like, bro, what the are you doing? And he's like, what, I thought we could slam. And, you know, I knew this was disingenuous because if he was going to slam, he could have done this a long time ago. Earlier in the match, he waited to the very end when he was losing and had no possible chance of making it up and just dumped the kid on his neck. I was very, very poor sportsmanship, you know. And again, one last thing, I've also had people come into my gym. And again, we do heel hooks in no-gi all day long, but we don't do them in the gi just for the simple fact that, you know, I don't want my students to get used to doing that. And then they go to a gi tournament and they can't, right? And so with that said, I've had guys come in, I mean, sit back with me in the gi and try to rip my damn heel off. And I got to tap out before, you know, they get a chance because they're not even like slowing down at all. They're just getting ready to rip and you can feel their muscles get around it. And it's been scary sometimes. So again, all that said, make sure that if you are a newer white belt, blue belt, whatever, or if you don't travel much, or if you roll with someone brand new in the future, always be very cautious and always be aware. Because again, this is a lesson I learned the hard way. Because people would do stuff that I wasn't used to or that I would consider kind of not cool, and I had to be ready for it. And this is a great example of something like that, right? Like nobody needs to be slamming teenage kids like that in the gym. Now, this said, I know an argument that's going to pop up. It always pops up when these kind of things happen. It did in the Instagram pages. One of the Instagram pages I was looking at where I saw this, when they were saying these, you know, they're talking in the comments, they said, see, this is why self-defense jiu-jitsu is superior to sport. And, you know, went on their little thing, and I'm sure we'll have a few people talk about it here. Here's the deal. I've gone to plenty of gyms that are, you know, Gracie gyms that are more self-defense oriented, right? But when you're doing rolling, when you're doing jiu-jitsu versus jiu-jitsu, you are sort of agreeing upon rules of engagement that do not involve slams and punches, right? Like if I went to a self-defense-based gym and we're doing jiu-jitsu versus jiu-jitsu, and then all of a sudden I start like elbowing people, they're going to be like, whoa, 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 what are you doing, bro, right? And that mindset, when you have agreed upon a certain set of rules, is very important. I know that for me, like when I was fighting MMA or when I was sparring and boxing, someone could punch me in the face and I kind of just eat it and kind of like, let's go, keep going, right? But then if I'm doing jiu-jitsu versus jiu-jitsu, sometimes I'll get hit in the mouth and I'm not expecting it, right? Like I've had guys like accidentally punch me, you know, they're reaching for my head or something and they deck me right in the mouth. I'm like, hold on a second, man, right? Because I wasn't expecting it. My body wasn't prepared for it. And it changes the way that my body perceived it. And so again, the rules that you agree upon is very important. It changes things. Now, to the credit of, say, like the self-defense type stuff, one of the things you could do, because I even saw one person say, you should allow slams and they should be legal in the gym. So if this way you train more realistic or whatever. Now, I don't think that's a good idea because I think, especially if you had some brand new white belt, could you, I could imagine having my white belt beginners class and allowing them to like pick each other up and slamming. I'm sure that's like, it would, all the big guys would just be like slamming all the little dudes around like dogs chew toys, right? It would be terrible. Bad idea, at least for their like long-term health and their brain function, right? But that said, one of the things maybe you could do if this is something you kind of want to kind of push upon, and you guys are welcome to comment down below with whether or not you think slam should be legal. You could do something like judo. Like one of my buddies was big into judo, and he said that in judo, what they would do is, let's say if you had me in an armbar, and I pick you up off the ground, or if you had me in a triangle, and I pick you up off the ground to where I could slam you, the ref will stop the match or you will let go. And the reason why is, number one, to protect you from getting hurt, right? So that you don't get injured. That was a rule they put in a long time ago to help make sure people aren't getting spiked on their spine and their neck, because that's not good. And then two, the other side is from a sense of realism, right? Like, I picked you up off the ground. I could slam you. We're going to stop the match and we're going to reset and go back to standing, right? And kind of get back to what we can do. So that's not allowed, right? And this is why I think I was reading about Dave Camarillo's book years ago. He was talking about when he did judo as a jiu-jitsu guy who he was doing both. He made sure that he would do these flying arm bars and try to catch the arm and even pop it as soon as he's hitting the ground. Because if the person can lift him off, he has to let go. And so anyway, that's the idea. I just wanted to share a couple things to chew on, a couple ideas. But the big takeaway from this is if you're new to jiu-jitsu, if you're new to grappling or within your first few years or whatever it might be, make sure that you do not roll with brand new people who you've never rolled with before as if they're going to abide by the normal rules and the normal types of stuff that you do in your gym. They may and most will. Like 99% of the time, it's going to be a cool roll. It's going to be fine. But always be cautious with newer people that you've never rolled with, whether it's a brand new person off the street or it's a random like higher belt that comes into the gym. You don't know them, you don't know what they're in there for, and you don't know what their mindset is and what they do at their gym. And again, everybody's a little different. And again, those kinds of situations, what you saw in that video, I've seen stuff like that happen, and so I don't want it to happen to you. So anyway, that's the video, guys. Hope that helps. We're at 10 minutes plus. I'm long-winded as always, but hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll talk to you next time.